Marty McSorley and Donald Brashear were known as some of the league's greatest fighters during their respective NHL careers. However, one incident between these two enforcers would forever live in infamy. Welcome back to another episode of Alternate Hockey History, the series where we revisit key moments throughout hockey history to see how an alternate outcome might have changed the history of the sport. In today's episode, we are going to be looking at the controversial incident between these two tough guys, as we ask, what if Marty McSorley didn't slash Donald Brashear? To remind you of what took place, allow me to take you back to February 21st, 2000. McSorley's Boston Bruins faced off against Brashear's Vancouver Canucks in General Motors Place. During the game, the two big men did what they were paid by their respective franchises to do and dropped the gloves. The young Brashear came out on top over the aging McSorley. On his way to the penalty box, Brashear decided to taunt the Bruins bench, which greatly angered McSorley. Later in the game, Brashear continued to cause trouble for Boston as he collided with Bruins goaltender Byron Defoe, which resulted in the netminder leaving the ice with a knee injury. McSorley was furious with Brashear and spent the rest of the game trying to get Brashear to drop the gloves again and answer for what he had done to Defoe. However, Brashear refused to fight. Then, with 4.6 seconds left in the game, McSorley, who was skating behind Brashear and still trying to engage with him, grabbed his stick with two hands and struck Brashear in the side of his head. Brashear collapsed onto the ice and his helmet fell off on impact. He suffered a seizure on the ice and a grade 3 concussion as a result of the slash. But say this slash to the head never happened. Would things have really been that different? Well, for starters, this event not taking place would certainly help Marty McSorley's lasting legacy in the league. Before his slash on Brashear, McSorley was most famously known around the league as the Great One's bodyguard. He was paid large sums of money just to make sure the star players on his team could do their thing without being pushed around. Wayne Gretzky wouldn't even move to the LA Kings unless Marty McSorley went with him. That's how much he meant to the greatest player to ever play in the NHL. However, with this event taking place after he and Gretzky had parted ways, and with it taking place during McSorley's twilight years of his career, he will likely become more synonymous with this event than what he did with the likes of Gretzky, as people often remember the most recent event over past events, whether the most recent event is good or bad. It's a shame, because McSorley was always seen as a versatile player who could play both forward and defense, and did everything he could to stick up for his teammates when opposing players were trying to take liberties. But he made the decision to slash Brashear in the head, and he has to live with that choice for the rest of his life. Also, this event not happening would mean that McSorley likely wouldn't be a convicted criminal. Let us not forget that the fallout from this incident was huge. McSorley was suspended indefinitely from the league and was tried in British Columbian court for assault with a deadly weapon. Brashear even testified during the trial, saying he had no memory of the incident as a result of the injury he suffered, whilst McSorley testified that he was trying to hit Brashear on the shoulder to get his attention, but missed and hit his head instead. McSorley was then found guilty of assault with a deadly weapon, and rather than go to jail, was given 18 months of probation, of which he was not allowed to play in a game against Donald Brashear. I think it's safe to say that if the slash never happened, McSorley wouldn't have been suspended by the league, he wouldn't have become a convicted criminal, and that game in February 2000 would have been just another game for these two enforcers. This situation is as good as any to highlight how one thing can really turn your life or your career upside down. The most interesting point to ponder, though, is the effect not slashing Brashear would have had on Marty McSorley's playing career. Whilst Brashear would luckily make a recovery and return to play for Vancouver for the end of the season, this incident was the last McSorley would see of the NHL. The aging enforcer missed the last 23 games of the season, and after his suspension was officially set to a full year by the league, McSorley decided to announce his retirement from the National Hockey League. Whilst he still could have played if this event hadn't taken place, as he wouldn't have been suspended indefinitely, I doubt McSorley would have seen much more time in the NHL past the 1999/2000 NHL season anyway. Considering he was 38 years old and in his 17th NHL season at the time, it's unlikely that McSorley would have stuck around in the league for much longer. Maybe another season or two if he was lucky, but not a significant amount of time compared to the career he had already had. However, on the flip side for Donald Brashear, this event not taking place doesn't really change all that much from what I can see. Whilst he would miss 22 games as a result of the injuries he suffered from this incident, Brashear's long-term career in the NHL luckily wasn't damaged. Brashear went on to play 636 NHL games over 10 seasons after the slash, as well as a further 106 games in 5 seasons outside the NHL. Brashear even ended up playing more NHL games in his career than Marty McSorley did. So if the slash never took place, other than the 20 or so games he missed after the incident, I doubt the rest of these numbers would have changed all that much. I don't know whether Brashear having a successful career after the slash and the subsequent seizure and concussion on the ice shows how tough of a cookie Brashear was to still have a great career after such a horrific injury, or just how lucky he was, as that injury could have easily have stopped his still young NHL career in its tracks. I guess we'll never know. Also, some might argue that perhaps if he didn't suffer such a horrific injury, Brashear might have gone on to be a more productive player in the points department over the years than just being a tough guy who racks up a ton of penalty minutes, that this injury potentially halted Brashear's progression and growth in the league. However, this theory is immediately debunked when you look at Brashear's numbers by season. Brashear actually had better point production after the slash incident than before. Before the incident, his career high points for a season was 18. And he came within 5 points of that total 6 times and eclipsed that number 3 times in the next 10 seasons. On paper at least, it appears as though nothing bad came out of it for him other than missing that 20 or so games. You could almost go as far to say that this incident actually helped Brashear become a better player in the NHL. Not something you would expect to hear out of something so brutal as this, that's for sure. So in conclusion, if McSorley never slashed Brashear on that now infamous night, the culprit's legacy in the league would be a lot less tarnished, whilst the victim of the incident would still likely have gone on to have a successful career. McSorley would have called it a day and hanged up his skates in one of the seasons that followed, whilst Brashear would have continued to do what he did best, getting under opponent's skin and letting his fists do the talking when needed. Amongst all this controversy, it's easy to forget that other than this one particular incident, these two players' careers and the way they played the game were more similar than you might think. And there you go. What do you think would have happened if Marty McSorley didn't slash Donald Brashear? Also, is there another alternate hockey history you would like me to explore in this series? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you guys think. But thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you have enjoyed. Please feel free to like, subscribe, share, or watch some of my other videos. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.